you're on camera, and I just want to ask a few questions, not too many. I just want to learn about
my history.
I want to learn a little bit about your history, especially when you got out of high school.
Got out of high school tonight, and I was on the train the next morning.
What high school you went to?
What high school?
Yeah.
St. John.
Where's that?
In Camden, South Carolina.
And where'd you grow up?
Where did I grow up?
Yeah.
In Lone Star.
Lone Star what?
Down there.
Lone Star. What state is that in?
South Carolina.
Oh.
Lone Star.
Oh, okay.
I'll show you some of these times where I grew up at in Lone Star. It's back though. Down the road of where a piece of whatever. Yeah. I was, I guess, about 13 or 14 when we moved up to Lone Star there, near one old house. Mom and Daddy old house.
Right.
That street. I guess I was about 13 or 14 or something like that when we moved there.
And then what'd you do after high school?
I told you I got on the train the next day.
Where'd you go?
Girls hats up in the air that night. Everybody throw their hats up in the air.
Uh-huh.
And the next morning I headed to Washington, D.C.
Who was in Washington, D.C.?
Mary.
Who's that?
My sister.
Oh.
My older sister.
Mary. Oh, okay.
I was in Washington, D.C. Yeah.
And what'd you do in Washington, D.C.?
I went to work to babysitter. Went to work for the Taylors. He was a cop. She was the secretary. He was a cop.
Mm-hmm.
And I went to work with him.
Oh, okay. What'd you do with them? Huh? What'd you do?
I was like a nanny of the house.
Oh, okay.
And I watched the kids. I didn't clean the house or do nothing like that. I just watched the kids.
Mm.
Get them ready for school.
Mm-hmm. And then what happened? What'd you do after that? How long was you in D.C.?
About 2 years, maybe.
And then what happened?
That's when I got pregnant and I went back to Lone Star. So I got pregnant, had the baby, and went back to Lone Star.
Who'd you get pregnant for?
Al Father.
Who?
Al. His name is Alfred Father.
Fowler?
Uh-huh.
How you spell that?
F-O-W-L-E-R.
So that was a high school sweetheart?
Nah. Not really.
Just a sweetheart.
Somebody sort of like to play around with.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So then what happened after you got pregnant? You guys was thinking about marriage or what y'all was thinking about?
No, I wasn't thinking about it. I was thinking about just getting away from him and forget the whole thing. Because he made one statement that I didn't like. And that did it. For me. I was finished after that. Yeah.
One statement.
Mm-hmm. Made a statement I didn't like. And that was the end of that. The thrill was gone.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
So Al messed up.
Big time with me. Well, that big time. As I was concerned, that was finished.
What did he do to mess up?
What the statement was? He'll wait and see after the baby is born. Then he decided whether or not he wanted to get married. So, in other words, he was saying he wasn't sure this was his baby. He had to wait until the seed and whatever. So, that was it.
Mama's baby, papa, maybe. Yeah, that's what he was thinking.
Yeah, whatever he was thinking, that didn't go well with me. That was the end of that.
So, did you stay in D.C.? So, what'd you do?
I came back home for Lone Star.
Mm-hmm.
And stayed here for a couple of months. Then I went to New York.
What year was that?
63,
So what happened after the baby was born?
I came to New York and started working.
Okay.
And then I go back home here after the, maybe 6 months, 9 months, something like that.
How'd you come to that decision? To leave your newborn baby and go to New York?
It wasn't nothing for me to do around in Lone Star as far as working and making a living or whatever. And I determined I wasn't going to work for no white people. And then I was coming through the back door and you sit in the back and eating there in front. I determined I wasn't going to do that. So I know I had to leave Lone Star to do something different. So that was my decision. To take care of my baby, to work and support it, and whatever. The best I know how.
So you had family support with the baby?
Mama was with mom and dad, was all right with her.
And then who'd you stay with in New York?
That's the name of it.
Where'd you stay? Where'd you live in New York at?
154 Putnam Avenue, Brooklyn, New York.
Wow.
Yep.
So you went from a remote rural town and called Lone Star, South Carolina, to the big city of Brooklyn, New York.
New York.
And Putnam, isn't Putnam in Flatbush? Where's Putnam at?
I guess Flatbush is not Brownsville or nothing like that. Not that far. But around Putnam and Nostrand Avenue, Franklin, you know about Putnam?
That's right. 154 Putnam. That's near kind of Bed-Stuy, Flatbush.
That was the house that everybody from Lone Star had this start from.
Like a boarding house?
No, it was a family house, but. You know, that was one of the places that people settled.
Now you had to pay rent?
$50 or something like that.
But
I lived with Queenie in her apartment. At first, and then I, after a while, I got a room downstairs. My room.
So how did you meet the love of your life?
Well, I knew the love of my life before I left. Before I got out of high school, before I left there, I met Putnam.
You met who?
You said the love of my life.
Yeah, what's his name?
Jimmy.
Oh.
What are you going to say?
I couldn't hear.
Oh.
You got to speak up.
I mean, before I even leave from down here, I was 16, 17 or something like that when I met him the first time. But then after, so high school and everything, he had already gone to New York, and then I went to New York. He was living in Manhattan, I went to Brooklyn. And one year when he came home, he came to my mom and daddy's house and got my address, phone number, whatever he called me.
So
the rest is history.
Hold on, we got some more history to talk about that. So,
you said you had a few questions.
Yeah, we had a few questions. So, what did you think about him when you first saw him when y'all was kids? What'd you think about him then?
When I first met him?
Very first time you met that young...
Jimmy?
Yeah. What'd you think about him? What was your first impression?
Not overexcited or whatever. It was, we used to sing. He sang in a group and I sang in a group. And we, all the time we would meet up is at a church sometime. They were on the program, we were on the program. So when I first thought of him, I didn't take him seriously because I might see him this Sunday night and I mean I'd see him for another month or two or whatever. So when I got the opportunity to go to Washington, he didn't know I was going. No telephone or whatever, and I lose contact with him like that. And after He came back home from New York, stopped by mom and dad, and got my phone number and address and stuff.
So how was the reunion in New York? What was that like? What did you think about him when you saw him then, as a grown man?
Well, I didn't think that much of him because he was supposedly, I heard, he was engaged.
Engaged?
To Johnson's first cousin. He was engaged when I met him, first met him. That he was engaged,
so. Let me get this right. So he went back to Lone Star, South Carolina, then he went to Lone Star, at least 30 miles away from where he from, to find out where you was at. Mm-hmm. Spoke to your parents, got your address, found out you was in Brooklyn, New York. Mm-hmm. He's in Manhattan, New York. Mm-hmm. And then...
And engaged.
And engaged. Mm-hmm. Can't leave that out. And then he said, hey, I'm going to go from Harlem to Brooklyn to track you down.
Yep.
But when you first saw him, you knew he was engaged at that moment?
No.
So what did you think when you first saw him as an adult male now?
Well, I don't know how I feel because I was just getting to New York. I didn't know nobody and didn't know him or whatever. So.
Well, you knew him as a child?
Yeah,
but
just grown now. I mean, hey, you know.
You were scared?
I just didn't believe nothing too much he said, and he gonna do this, and then he started playing the game at first. You know, when I first met him in Brooklyn, because he was already engaged, like I say. So this weekend he would come over. He said the next weekend he'd come over, but something came up and this and that. And that's when I heard about him being engaged. So I figured then that he was seeing the other girl on the odd weeks he wasn't seeing me. Whatever, so I didn't go too seriously. Until one night, we all meet up at a dance. I never knew the girl, never seen her, whatever. But we met up at a dance. And, he was dance with her, which I didn't know who she was. And then he would dance for me. He would be from this table to that table, whatever. And then I found out later that was the girl he was engaged to. Her name was Emily, and that's Johnson's first cousin. But I know Johnson and Mildred, and we all was hanging together, you know, partying, dancing and changing partners and all of that kind of stuff. But I didn't know it at the time. So
my daddy was a player.
Yeah. He thought he was playing, but he wasn't gonna play here long, you know. So after I find out about her, then I, you know, we engaged. More luck to you. Go ahead on about your business, but I wasn't gonna be bothered. But then he played that for a month or so, and then he had to cut that loose.
So then, how did the proposal go? How did the proposal go to you? How did he propose? What happened?
I don't even remember.
How much time had went by from that dance to you guys being serious?
Maybe like 6 months or so.
So you knew you loved him then?
I wanted to, but I didn't want to. I didn't want to show it. Yeah. Because I didn't know whether he was still seeing that other girl or whatever. But, I wasn't going to play no game.
So what year did you guys get married?
1966,
April 9th. Wow. What year you got out of high school?
1960.
So you had a very interested 6 years. A lot has happened. Living in three different states, two different lovers, a baby.
Yep, that's my story.
Well, thank you for sharing your story. This has been part one of Rosemarie Bristow's story. We started from 1960. And we ended at 1966. So there's a lot more to go in this story. We'll have to cut and paste them together, because maybe we'll start the next one out when she was a little younger, or maybe we'll start it out with her next children. Stay tuned. Thank you, Rosie. See you later.